People have been writing into Attention in the Pits, you guys don't show enough dragsters. Well, we're about to change that. Check out this super comp machine of Chris and Susan Garrettson. Chris, Blind Squirrel Racing, super comp dragster, but this one is different in just about every way possible. Why is that?
Well, with the top end stop, the little front wheels, the mufflers, I mean, it's like how many other things can somebody do that is oddball that what everybody else does? I mean, everybody wants to go fast. I don't need to go fast. I love going slow. I can't drive the finish line, so it's basically I dial the car and don't even look. I was at Maple Grove 3-4 weeks ago, runnered up, and the car was going ran 5 8-90s in a row, and then the air changed a little bit and I missed it on the in the final, naturally. But other than that, I mean, it's like I can't look. If I look, I screw up, so I just don't look anymore.
All right, so let's get up close. Let's look at this thing. First of all, Blind Squirrel Racing, is that him? Is that the Blind Squirrel, or are you Blind Squirrel?
Well, we're both of us are about the same. He's my, like, my guard dog, or the seeing eye dog that doesn't, you know, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't.
We talk about these super comp dragsters and how they all look kind of the same, but really there's a lot of personalization that goes into it. Let's explain for some of the folks out there what you're talking about, the top end throttle stop. Most people have their throttle stop set at the starting line area and they let some time go by and build huge speed, 160, 170, 180, sometimes 190 miles per hour, yep, to keep the race in front of them. And some smart guys decided, let's make it hard on those people and charge down the racetrack and shut the car off and coast. To what speed do you run?
Usually in really good air, I've had as low as 118, 119. And then when the air gets better, I have to modify a little bit. Usually about 126 to 127, but most of it, like the air here is like, I'm like 122. So it's like one, it's just a question of, you know, the air is more the factor of what it'll do and how it, because the motor is not a killer motor. I mean, it only ran like 80s, 165 when it was brand new in 2011 when it was built. So, I mean, it's got a little bit of longevity to it. I don't, you know, you don't have to need the fast car be really fast to run 890. I proved that 3 weeks ago at Maple Grove. So it just takes the people out of their comfort zone is the biggest reason. And like Alan Reinhart was saying, that, you know, why I do it is just for the sake of doing it. You know, it's something different. It's something oddball, and I've been an oddball all my life. So it's like, you know, just one more day after another.
This guy loves being an oddball. The mufflers, okay, those look like Flowmasters to me. I don't know what they are.
They are Flowmasters. These are the ones that, you know, they're a little bit bigger than the old ones that I used to have. The header setup, it was made by a man in Arizona for Ed Quay, and the problem was they ducked and went back too quickly on the bottom, and I had to like lengthen them almost like 3 inches because they were killing the motor like 2 3/10, and so once I fixed that, now they're fine and they don't hardly change it. And the thing is the quietness of it, because when I'm down there on the stop, I can hear a lot of stuff coming, and most of the things, the big mile an hour people make lots of noise, and that makes it better for me. But you know, the way the car's been running lately, I don't have to look. You know, it's just because, like I say, when I look, I screw up. So I don't look. I look, but I don't do anything. That's the big thing.
You trust your judgment. Well, you trust yourself. Trust the car.
Yeah, and I use
the force.
Yeah, and family software, you know, I use Bob Kododak's software stuff, and I mean, it works good, the car works good. The only person that could screw up is, like, the blind squirrel.
Let's look at the front end also, because these front tires, everybody remembers, I was there when Garlitz broke the speed record, 270 miles an hour on the Kevlar belts. These were the next version, the next generation. They're very rare now, but everybody started to go to them, and from what I understand, the drivability, like the feel, was better. You continue to run them. Tell us why.
Well, you used to run them on a dragster you had.
Yes, I did.
And I've always had these. I had them on my first Ed Quay car, and they steer nicer, they ride nicer because they have a better advantage on the sidewalls, and they start the clocks exactly the same way every time. But I shouldn't tell people that, but that's why one of the biggest reasons I do it. And it makes the little old guy look a little bit better in the lights. I had a 004 light and a 008 light this morning in two time runs. So it's like, even a blind squirrel can find a nut once in a while.
Twice in a while. Can we see you in the car?
Sure.
All right, let's let Garrettson get in his car. There's not only one way to do it in the National Hot Rod Association, especially in the .90 index classes. We've seen Tim Nicholson with his Lenco Camaro top-end throttle stop. We did an attention in the pits. St. Louis, he goes on to win the race. Yeah, so you never know.
Yeah, because like Tim Nicholson, Jody Lang, and I were featured in the National Dragster a couple of years ago as doing it from the behind. And it was like really funny, I never saw the thing. Somebody called me and told me it was in there, and I'm going like, what? So I read the thing, and it's like, wow. It was right after that year 2018 when I finished number six in the world and if I hadn't have screwed up two races, I might have been the world championship behind, and Steve Williams wouldn't have won it, but. Hey, woulda, coulda, shoulda.
Yeah, exactly. Drag racers, they don't remember when they lost or anything. They don't remember anything about it. Oh,
I do.
All right, so tell us about from burnout to the top end. What do you do in this race car?
Well, basically, I have the little lean-out switch so I can lean it out. Even though it's on gas, it makes it a little bit quicker. One button for the burnout, like 6,300. Then I go out, put it in low gear, turn the data recorder on, turn the throttle stop on, because I have the thing set so that when I back up, it doesn't cycle the air thing. So once I arm those two things, just go out there. I moved the button down because I was having problems with the thing on the side. So I moved it up on the top, and it's a much more comfortable place for the button, and then just let it go. And then, once it's set the timers and the thing, just drive, have fun, look around, and drive it out the back door, and don't worry about anything.
And either the wind light comes on or it doesn't. Can we hear this thing run?
Sure.
Yeah. All right, fire it up. You got power?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, those are Flowmasters. They sound great. We can have a conversation over the car.
Yeah, that's the thing. The mufflers, it makes it so much easier to hear things coming at you at 180 miles an hour. And, it's just, I've always had these on. I had them on my other car. I've had them on this car. Everybody says, oh, that thing sounds like a Mustang. I say, yeah, well, whatever.
Because every Mustang had Flowmasters on it. Wow, this is amazing.
Yep.
Chris Garrettson, Blind Squirrel Racing. And now I got to tell you, I love this car, but I hear it is funded by Susan.
Well, technically, yeah, I have to say it's a joint effort. We'll say that.
There you go.
Thank you. Being diplomatic.
Very, very political of you. That's good. Thank you for sharing your car with us.
All right. Thank you. I'm glad you could have this thing. And it's still fun. As long as I'm like almost 74 and I'm still having fun, as long as I can, like I tell Susan, as long as I can still get in and out of the car without a crane, I'm going to keep doing this. But once I get to the point where I can't get out of the car, and it's like, and this car was built for Ed Quay. And if anybody knows how big Ed Quay is, he's a little guy. And he's probably, I'm a little tight across the thing, but she won't let me buy another car.
Yeah, fits like a glove.
Yeah, a tight glove, a very tight glove.
There you have it, Chris Garrettson. He's a character, definitely not an oddball. This is why you come out into the pits here at the NHRA.